Thank you, Madam Chair. First of all, Mr. Lewandowski, I'm glad to hear that both of us share a deep love for this country and that both of us have a tremendous distaste for any foreign agents that may want to interfere with our democracy in this country. I'm going to ask you if you're familiar with George Papadopoulos.
I am.
And you agree that he was a foreign policy advisor for the Trump administration as of April 27, 2016?
To the campaign, Congressman.
To the campaign, correct?
To the campaign.
Yes. As you know, George pled guilty to felony crimes, including lying to federal investigators. We've got his indictment up on the screen. And one of those things he pled guilty to was lying about how often he was communicating with Russians, with Russia, when he was an advisor to the campaign. Correct?
I don't know if that's what he pled guilty to, Your Honor, sir. Okay.
It's in this slide. In fact, I'm quoting the Mueller report now. Throughout April 2016, Papadopoulos continued to correspond and meet with Russians and seek Russian contacts. And, of course, that's up on volume one, page 87, the slide. The report also documents Papadopoulos trying to schedule then-candidate Trump to travel to Russia to meet with Putin. Is that correct?
I don't know what's in the report, sir.
Okay. The report also documents emails discussing this potential Russian trip, and I'll show them to you in case you've not read them, correct? You can put those up, please. On April 27th, the Trump campaign foreign policy advisor, Papadopoulos, again, sent you, sir, an email telling you that he had, quote, been receiving a lot of calls over the last months about Putin wanting to host Trump and the team when the time was right. You know about that?
If that's what's in the report.
Volume 1, page 89.
Okay, that's the first I've seen it.
On June 1st, Papadopoulos forwarded you another email from a Russian official raising the possibility of meeting in Moscow, asking you if that was something that you wanted to move forward with. Is that accurate or not?
I don't know.
Volume 1, page 89. Slide, please.
I see the report, sir.
Okay. So I would say that this is just was not about you receiving information about coordinating potential meetings with Russia, but actually you responded to Papadopoulos, telling him to connect with Sam Clovis because he was going to be the running point man. Is that correct?
Yeah, I believe that to be accurate.
Okay. Did you tell Papadopoulos to stop communication with Russians?
I don't believe I did.
Okay. You actually encouraged that communication, correct, by referring him to a running point man, which is Mr. Clovis. Yes?
No, Congressman. What I was attempting to do with a contact from Mr. Papadopoulos, who I had very limited interaction with, was to put him in touch with a staff person who could have a more articulate and thorough conversation. It wasn't, while I ran the day-to-day responsibility of the campaign, 1,000 emails a day didn't allow me the privilege of responding in detail to each of them.
Candidate Trump has said that you and he were communicating 10 to 12 to 14 hours a day. Is that correct?
I'm not sure if that's what the president said, sir.
He did. Did you at all mention to candidate Trump these communications that Russians were having with the campaign?
Not to the best of my recollection.
Did you communicate with the family about these communications that were going on?
Not to the best of my recollection.
You and I both have a distaste for foreign agents affecting our democratic process. Did you report these incidences to the FBI?
I did not.
Did you bring it up to anybody's attention?
I think just Mr. Clovis, because I did not see that outreach to me as an offer to interfere with the outcome of the election.
What did you see it as?
I saw an outreach from a potential foreign agent to a senior policy, to a policy advisor, and that's why I asked him to get in touch with Mr. Clovis.
I mean, for the safety, just to be on the safe side, wouldn't you call the FBI and say, hey, these guys are calling us, please check it out?
You know, I think in hindsight, that's something that Mr. Clovis probably should have done.
So you got Russians hacking our elections, your campaign advisors talking to another campaign advisor about Russians interested in communicating with the campaign.
Congressman, I don't believe I ever had a communication of any Russians trying to offer to interfere in the outcome of the election.
But you did have knowledge, sir, of people in your campaign communicating with Russians.
The time of the gentleman has expired. The witness may answer the question.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.